What's up everyone, David here, and we're here today for another DC News episode where we are talking about JRPG news, and we have a bunch of interesting topic today. So just before I get right in, I want to let you guys know, if you don't already, there is an active giveaway on the channel for a copy of Shin Megami Tensei Nocturne HD Remastered, PS4 or Switch, digital or physical. All you have to do is be subscribed to the channel and click the link down in the description below to get a chance to win a copy. Now let's jump right in. The first topic that I was super excited to talk about, and again, if you guys are following me on Twitter, you saw me, I retweeted the information, and it is that Sega affirmed once again during their financial report that they want to bring more games to more platforms, and they are talking about older games, and they are talking about games that are currently in development, considering putting them on multiple systems. Obviously, they gave us that information that they wanted to go multi-platform a while ago, like a few months ago, and we saw changes. We saw the Yakuza series jump from PlayStation to Game Pass to Xbox and PC, which was super cool, and that is great news, but that's the only series that we saw moving to other systems. Obviously, we also saw the recent release of Persona 4 Golden on PC, which did extremely well, and it seems like Sega and Atlus are telling us once again that they are surprised with this success and that they want to bring some more of their games on other systems. As you guys know, we got the recent announcement for Shin Megami Tensei Nocturne Remastered to come to Switch and PC, and the PS4, sorry, which is really good news. This is coming spring 2021 for us in the West, and it's releasing October for Japan, okay? Now, what can we see next? Obviously, I feel like as Persona 4 Golden proved to be super successful on PC, I really do think that they will probably take advantage of Atlus and the Persona series and publish like a Persona 3 port on PC. I feel like this is something that would do extremely well. We talked about this on a podcast recently, but all they have to do is to just give the ability to control the whole team, the whole party, every single party member, just like in Persona 3 Portable, and maybe even add the answer from Persona 3 FES right in the port, up-res the graphics like they did with P4G, and it will be a massive success. Obviously, for now, we know that Atlus can't release Persona 5 Royal on other systems for now, but I think it's going to change eventually. So if they were to release vanilla P5 right now, either on PC or Switch, it would create like some type of outrage, so they probably want to avoid that. Will we see Persona 4 Golden on Switch? Maybe, but I really expect to be more ports now in the future, since this is the second time that Sega says that they want to put more of their games on other systems. Of course, it's not only Atlus. Yakuza is an amazing series that is now going multi-platform, and that is great news. Sega currently has a bunch of cool IPs under their hands, and if they want to put their games on more systems, I am down for that. So let's just keep a watch on that. Obviously, there's been a bunch of talk this weekend about which games would we like to see from Sega and Atlus get released on other platforms, or get in a remaster just like they're doing with Nocturne. As we discussed on the podcast, my pick would be the Raidu games for the PS2. The Devil Summoner Raidu games are super expensive, like they're $200 a complete copy here in Canada, so this is a bit expensive. Those games I really do want, and I'm a collector, as you can see with the shelf, so I want the physical games. Of course, if I want to replay them, I know you don't have to tell me, but I can also go on PSN and just buy them for like $10 on PS3. But a remaster on new systems would be amazing for those games, and that is my pick. Now let's jump right into the next topic. We've seen a bunch of amazing sales number last week. We got numbers for Nintendo, a bunch of titles for Nintendo, but one title in particular is Xenoblade Chronicles Definitive Edition. If we go all the way back to the release of Xenoblade Chronicles 2, Nintendo announced roughly 1 year after release that the game sold 1.7 million units, which was really good. But now if we look at Xenoblade Chronicles Definitive Edition, the game launched at the end of May this year, and they announced last week during Nintendo's financial report for the first quarter of the year that Xenoblade already shipped 1.3 million units, which is amazing. Really good sales overall for Monolith Soft and Nintendo. The Xenoblade franchise is really getting up there with the big names, and it's super great to see because those games are amazing. If you guys have not tried Xenoblade Chronicles Definitive Edition yet, I really do recommend the game. It's extremely good. I'm currently replaying the game on the Switch. I'm a bit late, I know, but I plan to give you guys a review once I'm done with the new experience on Definitive Edition, and I also can't wait to try the future connected content that I haven't played on back on the Wii days since this is new content. So this is it for Xenoblade Chronicles, and we also got amazing sales numbers for Final Fantasy VII Remake. Square Enix announced this weekend that Final Fantasy VII Remake shipped over 5 million copies worldwide since its release. It's been a few months only. Honestly, it's no surprise, this game is on a major scale. The graphics, the story, and just the development overall has been a big accomplishment for the Square Enix team, and congratulations for them for the big numbers. It's great to see. Final Fantasy VII Remake is a great game. It's not a perfect game, but it's definitely a really cool experience. We gotta remember that this is not the complete Final Fantasy VII experience, as this is just the part one. We will probably hear about a part two, part three later down the line. But hey, great numbers, and I'm always down for seeing RPGs reaching new heights. Now, what I want you guys to look at now is Atlus posted new screenshots of Shin Megami Tensei Nocturne HD Remastered, and as you all know, I'm super hyped for this release, so let's look at the screenshots together. So as you can see, guys, there's a bunch of cool screenshots. Honestly, the graphics are really crisp. We got to remember that this is like a 2003, if I'm not mistaken, release, and it's on the PlayStation 2. So looking at those graphics, man, it's really impressive. Like, there's one picture in particular, and it's the picture where you're casting a Zio spell, and you can look at the effect, like all the lightning going down from the sky, and it's really beautiful. I can't believe, looking at the screenshot, that this is a PS2 game. Honestly, I really do think that they're doing an amazing job with the look of this game. Obviously, it's not gonna look like a Final Fantasy VII Remake, since this is just a remaster of an older game, but for the type of game that it is, I really do think it looks extremely good. Just looking at the overworld map as well, when you're traveling, it doesn't look as bland as it did back in the day, so obviously we're 17 years down the line, but it still looks amazing from what I can see, and I'm extremely hyped. I can't wait to play this title. Of course, I'm going to be picking it up day one. I hope that they'll bring a collector's edition here to the West as well, since this is something that I would definitely want to pick up if it ends up coming out in the West as well. The collector's edition that they announced for Japan obviously sold out extremely quickly, but hey, if they bring anything to the West, I will be picking up this game. And again, if you guys want a chance to win, please enter the giveaway and hope that you get a chance to win. And good luck if you decide to register. But I will be covering SMT3 Nocturne once it comes out and until release as well. So you guys, if you want to stay up to date, please consider subscribing. Now, this is it for this week's news. I just wanted to do a quick segment, and it's news about the YouTube channel and updates about the channel. I have two things that I want to let you guys know. If you haven't seen it, on Sunday, last Sunday, I was on a podcast on my Kuro's channel, so on the Midnight channel, and we were with a bunch of cool dudes. We were with Skull from the Fan Site, we were with Spencer from SMT Network, and LaRue as well. So it was a really great podcast. We talked about a bunch of things. We talked about SMT5 a bit, but of course we went off topic and talked about a bunch of various subjects. And as Spencer predicted, the podcast was pretty long. Like, we talked for over 4 hours about anything SMT, but it was great. I'll add the link to the podcast down in the description below if you guys have, for whatever reason, 5 hours to waste listening to us talking about things. Well, you can click the link. It was definitely a great time, and thanks to you, Kuro, for having me on. It was great. If you haven't seen it, I'm super happy to announce that we reached 1,000 subscribers on the channel last Friday. Again, I'm super grateful, guys. I never thought that I would reach such a milestone in such a short period of time. I'm super grateful. I'm extremely happy to see that you guys enjoy the content. As always, if you have anything you want to tell me, if you have any suggestions for me going forward with the channel, please let me know. I can't answer every single comment, but I'm always reading every single one of you guys' comments, so if you have anything to say, please let me know. And as always, if you like the video, please consider a little thumbs up. It helps to support the channel. And if you want to stay up to date on anything Megaton, Persona, Atlus, or JRPGs in general, if you like those weekly JRPG news episode, you can always click the subscribe button, and we will see you guys in another video.